brief summary of the Maillard reaction is we need the presence of protein, carbohydrates, we need amino acids, and we need reducing sugars. So one of the comparisons that I always like to say to people is that there's commonality in the Maillard reaction in how we cook our steak or our roast beef at home, because we've got sugar, we've got protein in that. The way the milk browns on the steam wand, it's protein in milk, we have sugar in milk, so obviously that helps with the browning of that particular substance. Also coffee, we talk about that as well, and then also in the production of cocoa and chocolate. The Maillard phase is a very important phase, because it really sort of helps determine the sort of the physical weight or the molecular structure of the coffee. And so the longer we stretch and we sort of spend time in this particular phase, we create more molecular structure or more molecular weight in the coffee, and therefore it becomes thicker or more viscous, more syrupy, so we have a heavier mouthfeel. If we shorten the Maillard phase, we have a shorter phase within that, then what happens is we have less molecular weight, so the coffee becomes thinner, it becomes a little bit more wispy, but we get a greater clarity of flavour. So I guess it's always the trade-off of whether we're wanting that really light, sort of easy to drink sort of style, or do we want something that's really heavy and viscous and with lots of kind of complexity in it. How I know we're in the Maillard phase is when the coffee transitions from green, from when we first start, to going from a white colour. And as it transitions from white to yellow, this is the commencement of the Maillard phase. So it's a visual sort of signpost that we use in the roasting process. We can link some aromas to that if we're wanting to pull the trier out. You will find some basmati rice, some of those sort of toasty, doughy, baker kind of smells kind of coming into the coffee at that point. Still a little bit of dampness, but not a lot. Most of that sort of dampness is removed, that damp smell. Because for the Maillard reaction to happen, the presence of water needs to be reduced significantly as well. So you will notice a reduction in that as well.